Hello guys, welcome to my channel Linux Developer, and in this video I am going to show you how to create a sign up page with login page using MySQL database JSP servlet. Okay, so let me first show you what we are going to build. So we are going to build this sign up page where user will enter his username. Suppose I am entering my username and password. After when I click on the login, you can see I login successful and I am getting my home page. It can be any home page. This is my home page. I will provide you the code for this template. You can just watch the video. I will provide a link to this template. Okay, so you can see logged in username is shown here, which is Sunil Yadav, and when I click on log out, it will logged out. Okay, and if user has not registered yet, so he has to register first. So he will go to sign up page. Here he will, suppose I want to register, and my email ID is, he has to put the email ID tonystark@gmail.com. okay, and password, repeat password and contact number. Okay, and when you click on register, so you can see congrats, account created successfully. Okay, and now he can go to the sign up page, and here he will enter his username, and username is email ID and password which he has entered. So when I click on login, you can see it is logged in, and if you can see if I am entering any wrong email ID or username or password. So when I click on this login button, I am getting this, sorry, wrong username and password. So this is a validation. We will do that. I will show you how to create this, how to do this. So let's start. So first let me show you how we are what will be the backend process. So I have created a slide. So you can see first we have user will register. So let's understand the registration flow first. So here this is our user. He will request for the registration page first. So he will get the registration page. Registration page means this one. Not this one, this is sign up page. This is, okay, sorry, by mistakenly I have named this sign in page as sign up page also. So here it will be sign in page. Okay, and create an account, this will be the sign up page, and here he will enter all the details. So in this slide he will enter all the details here in the registration.jsp page, and after entering the details he will click on the submit button. And just remember this URL, this is important, because by using this our web container means here we are going to use Tomcat. So Tomcat will understand which, for which servlet we are sending the request. Here we have sent in the, if you remember, in the form tag we have to specify the action, like for which action we are going. First we have to specify the method, like which method we are using, like post or get, and after that we have to specify the action. Action means to which servlet we will send this request. Okay, so it will map to a particular servlet. Here we have sent register, so it will call a registration.java servlet. This is a servlet, it is dot java means this is a servlet class. How we will conclude that it is a servlet? Because it will extend HTTP servlet class, so it will become servlet. Okay, and this is JSP page. And now request will go to this registration.java page, and he will this registration.java page, what it will do, it will take all the details and insert into database. So sorry, I have not mentioned the database here. So suppose here there is a database. After getting all this detail, it registration.java page will insert that detail into the database table. We will have a table called users. In that table it will insert all the details, and if the details are inserted successfully, there is no error, then this method will return success and it will go to registration page with status as success. And if the details are not inserted, then status will be failed and we will go to registration page. And by using this status, we will show the message to the user whether the registration is successful or not. Okay, so after entering the details into the database, it will return to the registration.jsp page with the status. Okay, this status is success, then we will show registration successful. Okay, and after registration, let's see the login flow. So first user will request for the login page. He will get the login page and he will enter the details and he will click on the login. He or she, anyone, click on login, and this URL we have to specify in the action attribute in the form tag, and we will get the login.java page, and the login.java page is servlet. Okay, it's a servlet and it will validate the username and password by using with the help of database. So it will check whether the details are present in the database or not. So here I have mentioned the sign up table. It can be any table like users table or any table. So we are going to create this users table. Okay, users table, and we will check whether the user email and password is present in that users table or not. Okay, if the username and password is present, then we will make the status a success and we will go to home page our. Okay, home page means our landing page, and if the status is failed, we will go to login.jsp page with the message wrong username and password. Okay, so here you can see if the status is success, we will go to home.jsp, and if the status is failed, we will again we will go to login.jsp with the message wrong username and password. Okay, so let's see what are the like what will be the steps to create, so it will be easier for us to build. So first we will create a dynamic project. Okay, so let's just create a dynamic project in the Eclipse. So open your Eclipse IDE. So what we have to do, we have to create a dynamic project. So go to new dynamic web, select dynamic web project. If you are not seeing this option, go to others, and here dynamic web project. Okay, you can see here. If you are still not able to find out this dynamic web project here in the select wizard, then you might have downloaded the wrong Eclipse IDE, because there are multiple editions of Eclipse IDE are present for enterprise development and from normal development. So make sure you have downloaded the Java EE version for enterprise development of Eclipse. So select this option, dynamic web project, and click on next, and provide a name. So I'm gonna provide it as a sign up. You can provide any name, and the name should match to your project which you are creating. And in the target runtime, we are going to use the Apache Tomcat server. And I have Apache Tomcat already, but I will show you how to create embed this Apache Tomcat in the Eclipse. So I have already embedded the Apache Tomcat, that is why I am getting this suggestion. You might not get any suggestion. So before creating this web project, let me show you how to embed this Apache Tomcat in our Eclipse, because we will be using this Apache Tomcat server to create any dynamic web projects related to JSP servlet. We need a web container or a server, so we need to use a server. So we are using Apache Tomcat. So in the server tab, you can see I have this server. So let me delete this server first. Okay, so initially you will not be having this server. So I don't have any server here, you can see. So just go to the server tab. If you are not seeing the server tab, just go to Windows, show view, and here you can find the servers. Okay, so this server tags, and click on the no servers, click here to create a new server. In this, select the Apache Tomcat version. So before doing this, you have to download the Apache Tomcat. So go to internet and simply use download Apache Tomcat 9. Okay, and from Apache official website, you can download Apache Tomcat. Just download this zip version. Okay, 64-bit Windows zip. Just download this, so you can see it is downloaded, and once downloaded, just extract this. So I'm gonna extract here, and you can see I have got this folder I have got. And now just go to your Eclipse, select this Apache, this Tomcat 9, and click on the next. Okay, sorry. After doing this, what you have to do, you have to go to the server runtime environment and click on add. So, and here you have to select the Tomcat installation directory. Okay, so click on browse, and I have downloaded in the downloads. Go to the folder where you have downloaded the Apache Tomcat. So here you can see I have this Apache Tomcat. Just go to inside this folder and select folder. Now you can see, let's just finish, and now we can do the next or finish. Okay, so we have, let's just start this, verify it is working or not. Just click on start. I think in my case it will not work, but in your case it will work, because I have this the Apache Tomcat by default uses the 8080 port number, but in my system already another application is running on that port. So to change the port, here you can see double click on this Tomcat server, double click, you will get this interface, and just edit the port here. I'm gonna make it 8082 and just save, control S, and it will be saved. And now if I start this, you can see it is started successfully. It is starting in the console. You can see it is starting, no problem. Okay, and now we are gonna create this dynamic project, create dynamic web project, and give project a name, sign up, and select the Apache. I have added this Apache Tomcat version 9.03. So just select this in target runtime and dynamic web module version 4.0 and click on next, and make sure to generate the web.xml descriptor file. So click on the finish, and we got our sign up page. Okay, so we got our sign up project, and now you can see in the web.xml here we have to specify all our configurations basically. So you can use this file, or you can use the annotations provided by the Java to configure your servlets. So I'm gonna just to in the welcome file list, I want to add a welcome file, index.jsp. So I will create one index.jsp page to check whether my project is working or not. So go to new in the web app, new JSP file, and index.jsp, and just write here hello world. Okay, and let me right click on the sign up page, run as run on server. Okay, and restart the server, and you can see we will get this hello world printed on our browser. It is, you can see, that means our project is working. So let me just delete this index.jsp. okay, and make sure in the welcome file you have index.jsp, because we will open the index.jsp page first. Whenever we will run our signup project, the first page which will be open is index.jsp page. Okay, and let's go to our PowerPoint. Let's see the next step. So we have to add the required jars. So the required jars are MySQL. Okay, so MySQL we have to add first. So to add MySQL, we have to add that MySQL in the lib folders. So go to web browser, write download MySQL connector 8.0. You can download any version. Okay, so here you can see in the jardownload.com, there is a website jardownload.com. here, from here you can download this MySQL connector. So click on download, and it is downloading. Now just extract this folder. Okay, let me just open where it is. So in the downloads folder, you can see I got this. So let me just extract this, extract here. So you can see I have got this MySQL Java. We need only these jar files. Okay, so MySQL connector Java it. So we have to add this in our lib folder. So just simply drag and go to your Eclipse, and here in the lib folder just paste this. Okay, and it is here. Okay, so we got this here, and now what we have to do, let's see the next step. The next step is add Tomcat server to Eclipse, which we have already done, and then create and login and registration page. Before that, I think we should create the database. So for the database, I am using the MySQL. To download the MySQL, just type in your browser download MySQL database for Windows. You will get this dev.mysql.com download MySQL installer, and just download this first one, my Windows MSI installer. Click on download, then it will show this page. Just below you can see no thanks, just start my download. I think it would be better if you download the below one, this one. Okay, just download this one and click on no thanks, just start my downloads, and it will start your download. I already have the MySQL database in my system. Let me show you. If I have a MySQL command line, you can use any client. If you are using PHP MySQL, PHP MyAdmin, then you can also use PHP MyAdmin. And if you are using MySQL Workbench, they you can use. I am using MySQL command line. Okay, so you can also use this MySQL Workbench, no problem. So here I have this database company. Okay, and here we have to create a table. Create table, users, and first, if you have not created any database, first create database. So let me show you how to create database. Create, simply type create database, and database name is, suppose I'm gonna name it as YouTube. Okay, the database is already exists. So use this above command, create database YouTube, and now just use this database. So I'm gonna type use YouTube. So database is changed. Now we are inside the YouTube database, and we have to create a column, sorry, not column, a table. So if I can use this MySQL Workbench also. Let me just stop and show you. So you can see I have Workbench. If you are getting confused, so let me simply use this Workbench, then you will understand much better. So I'm gonna put my password, and here I have database use YouTube. I have shown you how to create a database use YouTube. You can see use YouTube executed. To execute, you have to just select the command and press Control Enter. It will be executed. Use YouTube, and now we have to create a table. Create table, users, and what will the first column will be? ID, int, it will be primary key, and it will be auto increment. Okay, and now the next field will be uname means username, and it will be of type varchar, and the size will be 50, and next field will be upwd means user password, and it will be also of type varchar 50, and next field will be uemail means user email, and it will also be a varchar type, varchar, and 50, comma, the last field will be umobile means mobile number, user's mobile number will also be type of varchar, 20, ओके. सो जस्ट कंट्रोल एंटर एंड यू कैन सी द टेबल इज़ क्रिएटेड. बिलो हियर यू कैन सी, लेट मी शो यू, कैन सी क्रिएट टेबल यूज़र आई डी एंड प्राइमरी की इज़ एग्जीक्यूटेड. नाउ लेट मी चेक. सो डिस्क्राइब कमांड इज़ डिस्क्राइब यूजर्स, इट विल डिस्क्राइब आवर यूजर्स टेबल. सो यू कैन सी वी हैव दिस टेबल विथ आई डी यू नेम यू पी डब्ल्यू डी एंड यू मोबाइल, ओके. एंड प्राइमरी की इज आई डी एंड वी विल यूज़ यू ई मेल एंड यू मोबाइल कॉल, सॉरी, यू ई मेल एंड यू पी डब्ल्यू डी कॉलम टू वेरीफाई द यूजर्स वाइल लॉग इन, ओके. सो वी हैव क्रिएटेड दिस टेबल यूजर्स इन द डेटाबेस एंड नाउ इफ आई शो यू माई दिस कमांड लाइन हियर यू विल हियर ऑल्सो यू कैन सी द टेबल विच आई हैव क्रिएटेड डिस्क्राइब यूजर्स, ओके. द ओनली डिफरेंस इज बाई यूजिंग MySQL Workbench यू विल गेट अ जी यू आई सो दैट इट यू वुड अंडरस्टैंड मच बेटर. सम पीपल लाइक जी यू आई, सम पीपल डोंट लाइक जी यू आई. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू योर प्रेफरेंस यू कैन चूज टू वर्क विद MySQL Workbench और दिस वन और कमांड लाइन, ओके. सो नाउ वी हैव क्रिएटेड द टेबल एंड नाउ वी हैव टू क्रिएट द लॉग इन एंड साइन अप रजिस्ट्रेशन पेज. सो वट we have to do, you will find a link in the description where you will find this. Let me just you can download this login project.zip file from the description link. So just download this and extract. So I have downloaded, let's extract here and you will get this folder login project and you will get all these files. So what you have to do, you just simply control A, copy this file and paste in the web app folder, okay. So copy and go to web app and okay. Okay, so we have got all the files. So this is our login page, okay, and this is registration.jsp page and this is index, our home page, okay. So first when we will run our project, we will get this index.jsp page. So let me show you the code for these three files. So this is our index.jsp file, this is our home page, okay. So this is simply a template which I have downloaded from the internet, not a rocket science. I have provided this to you. So I have downloaded this from the internet and this login.jsp page, because my main motive is to show you how to validate a username and password and means backend process. What will the backend process? My main intention of this video is to show you that, okay, what happens and backend, okay. So I'm not focusing on the front end part. You can just simply download these files and paste into the web apps folder, you will get the front end, okay. So what you have to just remember, you can see in the method and in the action we have to specify some values. I will tell you that. So let's just see the indexed login.jsp page code. So this is our label, okay, username, and you can see the input type text and name of the field is username. This name attribute is very important, because using this name attribute we are gonna fetch the values of this input fields. This input fields means whatever value the user will enter, we will fetch that value using the field name at servlet side, okay, in the servlet pay, in the servlet.java class, registration.java class, which is a servlet. In that servlet we will use this name to fetch the data, okay, this name. So username, password, and for, okay, so it is login. And similarly in the registration page also we have a form. Can see the form and method and actions are there, and you can see the form. In the form, input type is text and name is name. This is for email field, this is for password, repeat your password. And you might be wondering, I have not created a column in the database to store the repeat password, but in real time we don't need to store the repeat password, because we already have stored the password. We can compare that. It is just for the user, so that the user might not have entered any wrong passwords. So after doing the repeat password, he will remember his password, okay. So that is why we provide this field. and in the database table we don't create our separate field to store this repeat password, okay. And in the contact, you can see the for the contact we have the input type text and name is contact. For the email, you can see I have type email, and then it will validate the whether the entered data is email format or not. If you are entering any name, let me show you. If I have entered my name, suppose, and email ID I have entered like this. This is a wrong email ID because it doesn't contain the @ symbol. Okay, so when I click on the register, you can see it is showing me this message. Please include as @ in the email. Okay, so it will validate. That is why the type is email. Okay, and now I hope you understand this code. It is simple form, and there is a button called register. You can see this register button, and when will user will click on register button, then whatever value we have specified is in this action attribute, the server will call that servlet. Okay, so let me show you. Let's just first run the sign up our project. Run on server and finish. Okay, you can see we are directly getting this index page. Okay, so it should not be happen like we should not get this our home page. First user should get the login page. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to put a validation in the index.jsp page. Okay, so here first we have to check whether user have logged in or not. For that we are gonna use this tag, and inside this we are gonna put a if condition, if session dot get attribute and name is equal to null, means user have not logged in. Okay, so I will set this attribute when user will log in the login validation. When we will do the login code, I will set this attribute in the session. So when the user will log in, this attribute will return the username. Okay, if it is not returning username, that means it is null, then user have not logged in. I will show that in when we will do this login code. Okay, so session dot get attribute name equal to null, then we will simply redirect to the user to the login page, send redirect, and simply we'll go to login.jsp page. Okay, so you might be wondering, I have not created this session object. Like generally we create objects like http session is equal to a new http session, but how I am using this session object and this response object, because in JSP there is a concept of implicit objects. JSP provide us implicitly some objects, we don't have to create that. Here you can see, if I hover on the, you can see the http session, it is of type http session type, and this JSP already implicitly provide us this, we don't have to create. Let me show you this. You can see here JSP implicit objects, there are 9 JSP implicit objects. These are created by the web container means in our case the Tomcat. Okay, the Tomcat is creating the session and request, and there are 9 implicit objects: out, request, response, config, application, session. So we can directly use this, we don't need to create this concept in the Spring called dependency injection. You can you can understand that. Okay, so response dot send redirect and save, and let me just run it again. Run as, run on server, then we should get our login page. Okay, so we are getting this login page. So this should not be sign up page, it should be sign in page. So let me just change the label sign in. Okay, I am saved, and if I refresh, you can see sign in page. Okay, so and now first we have to do the registration part. So when user have to enter the all the detail, and when we click on the register, then we are gonna save all the details into the users table. Okay, so just go to registration.jsp, and here first let's just create a servlet class. So in the src main java, create a package. Always it is better, it is good practice to create a package unique developer dot registration. Okay, so all why we create package, because it is very easy to understand the classes which are related to registration. Suppose we have many classes, okay, so if we have created package, so we will understand like I have created for registration, I have created this package like registration, so I will know that all the classes related to registration process will be stored in this package. Okay, and similarly if I am building suppose e-commerce website where I have this products information, so I will create another package called com.uniquedeveloper.product, and all the related classes to that product process I will store in that package. Okay, so it is better to create a package. In real time we use this package approach very frequently. Okay, so now we have to create a servlet. So simply go to new and servlet. If you are not seeing servlet here, go to others and simply search for servlet and click on next and give a name. I am gonna name it as registration servlet. Okay, and we got our servlet. So I don't need these methods, I need only the do post method. And okay, and this is also not required. So why do post method? Because from the registration.jsp page, the method which we are gonna use is post. So type post here. Okay, make sure the method type is post. That is why we are using here post method. Okay, do post. If we are using here get, then we have to use the do get method. Okay, but to send, we here what we are doing, we are sending the data to the server like name and email, password. Okay, so to send the data we should use post, and to get the data we should use get. Okay, so do post is here, and you can see this @webservlet annotation, and we have to specify the parameter, the name here which we have specified in the account, in the form action tag. Okay, so if I type here register, okay, so register, so in the registration.servlet here you have to make it as register. Okay, these two values should be same, this value and not index in registration, this value should be same. Okay, so when user will click on this register button, it will search for the servlet having the web servlet having the name as register. Okay, so here make sure these two names should be same. Okay, register and this register. Okay, you can do this configuration using the web.xml file also, but it is much easier way to use the annotation. Okay, and now let's get the print some message so that we can validate whether it is working or not. So I'm gonna create a object of print writer, out is equal to response dot get writer, and I'm gonna just print out dot print working. Okay, so let me just run this application, run on server. And we have to go to create account. Okay, enter the details, any detail you can enter, password, and register, and you can see we are getting this working. That means our request is going to that servlet. Okay, our request is coming here. Okay, so what we have to do now, we have to get all the details entered by the user. Okay, so for how we will get that, first we have to get the this name. We have to see the name for the name, username is name, so we have to use the string uname, and string uname equal to request dot get parameter method is there to get the values. So parameter, we will pass the name. Why I have passed the name here? Because in the registration Java page, JSP page, you can see the for the name text field, the name is name. Okay, for this the name is email. So by using this name, we can get the user provided data in the servlet. Okay, why I'm calling this a servlet class? It is simply dot Java class, because it extend the HTTP servlet, so it gets all the methods which are present in HTTP servlet class. So by default it also become a servlet. This is called a inheritance. Okay, so request dot get parameter name, so we got name. So similarly we have to get the email. Uemail is equal to request dot get parameter uemail. Sorry, let's see what is the name. It is simply email, so copy this and email. Now let me create two more. Okay, so the string is wrong, make sure the spelling should be correct, small t. Uname email and upwd, and what is the name for the password field? It is password. Okay, so copy this name and come here and paste here. We got the password, and the last field is umobile. And what is the name for the mobile field? Mobile contact. Okay, contact, the name is contact, so paste here contact. So let's just print this all the details to check whether we are getting the that details or not. Response dot get writer. Okay, and out dot print uname. Okay, so let's just print all the details. Uname, uemail and upwd, similarly umobile. Okay, now let me run this. Run as, run on server, next, finish, restart the server. And go to create account, and here let me just enter my name, email, password I am entering 123 and 123, contact is any number I can enter, and when I click on register, you can see I am getting all the details. My username Sunil Yadav, email is this one, password is, why I have not got the password? I think this is my, okay, password I am getting as null. You can see why I am getting this as null. Let me check in the registration. Password. Okay, the field name is pass. Okay, so I by mistake I took this one, but I should take this one, the pass. Okay, don't make this mistake, pass. Now I will get. Okay, so everything is working. So what we have to do is, now we have to write the database code. Okay, try catch, inside this try catch we will write our database code to insert this detail into database. First we have to load the driver class, class dot for name, we are using MySQL, so com dot MySQL dot JDBC dot driver. This is the class name, make sure the D should be capital, and this is the package name, com.mysql.jdbc, and this is the class name. Okay, driver.java class there is present. If I show you the in the leaf folder, MySQL, not here. You can see in the web library MySQL connector which we have added. So here you can see com.mysql.cj, cj.jdbc. In that you can see there is a class called driver. You can see driver class. You can after MySQL, after I think MySQL 5, the package name is changed. So it is com.mysql.cj. I think okay, cj.jdbc. If you are not providing this cj, don't worry, Eclipse automatically take this class only. Okay, the driver dot class present. Okay, com.mysql.cj.jdbc.driver. Now we have to create the connection. So connection con is equal to driver manager. There is a class called, and make sure to use all these classes from java.sql package. Okay, java.sql connection driver manager should be from java.sql package. Dot get connection, and connection is jdbc colon mysql colon localhost colon 3306. By default the port number for MySQL is 3306. Okay, and date after this we have to provide our database name. So I have created this YouTube database. Okay, here you can see I have created this YouTube, use YouTube. You can create a database like create database YouTube. It is already present, that is why it will throw me error. You can see it create already, can't create database, all database exist. Okay, first create this database, then use that database, then create table. Okay, and we have to use this database, and after that comma, and provide the username root and password root. This is my username and password. If you have you have to enter your MySQL username and password. Okay, if you don't have any password, then simply make it as blank like this. Okay, if but I have password root. And after that create a prepare statement object. Prepare statement java.sql pst is equal to I have to write the insert query. So pst is equal to con dot prepare statement. Here we have to provide the SQL query. So the SQL query will be insert into users. Users is our table in the database. Users, and we have to provide the column names. So the columns are, what are the columns? So just describe users. You can see uname, upw, uemail and umobile. Okay, so enter exactly here. So uname comma uemail comma upwd, after that uemail, upwd comma uemail, and then umobile. Okay, umobile, and after that let me just close this sidebars, it is confusing me. Okay, umobile and values, and simply we have to put placeholders here, four placeholder we have to put here, not here, inside this. Okay, so this is our query, insert into users value, and now we have to set the values for these four parameters. So we have four column names here, that is why I have entered four placeholders, 1 2 3 4, and one by one in the same order we have to set the values for this. So pst dot dot set string, first is index start from 1, here in the JDBC index start from 1, so not 0. So this is 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. Okay, so first place we have to paste the set the uname, and then pst dot set string. Second I have to umobile, not umobile, upwd, and the third one is pst dot set string. Why I'm using set string method? Because all these are varchar type, So where string is equivalent to where char, okay? So you mobile is not you mobile, you email should be there. And now the lastly pst dot set string, fourth position is for you mobile, okay? Now we have to execute. So pst dot to execute, it is a non-select query, so we have to use the execute update method, execute update. And this method will return the number of row affected. So just store in the row count. We have inserted this record. So if the row count, we have to write a condition, if row count is greater than 0 means record inserted. What this row count will store, this it will store the number of record. In this case, it will store the number of record inserted. So we have here we have inserted one record, so it will contain one. So here we will check if the record insertion is failed. We suppose there is a problem and this record is not inserted into the database, then we will get minus one or something. It will depend on the type of driver we are using. So if it is greater than zero means the record is inserted. So what we will do, if the record is inserted, we will create a set and say we will go to we will redirect to the login page with the message not login page in the registration page with the message called user account created, okay? So for that, first we have to create the dispatcher servlet object. Dispatcher servlet, not dispatcher servlet, request dispatcher, and dispatcher equal to null, okay? And here I have to in the request dot set attribute, set attribute I will set as status is success means record inserted, and the page will be request, not request, this we have to initialize the dispatcher. Let's just initialize this above dispatcher of before if dispatcher is equal to request, not this request dot get request dispatcher. And here we have to provide the path for the login page. Not login, so registration page. So what is the name of our registration.jsp page? This name. So just enter this name here, registration.jsp, enter the name correct, and okay, so remove this extra space. And in the else part, what we will do, we will set the request status as failed, okay? Failed. And after that we will dispatcher dot forward and request and response object, just pass this request and response object. And in the catch block, simply print the exception, and you can use finally block also to clear, not finalize, finally. Here we can close our connection, con dot close, okay, connection, not connection, the object name is con dot close one, okay, because I have created this resource inside this try block. So you can see I have created this connection inside this try block. The because of that I am not able to use this in the finally block. So what I have to do, I have to create this outside of try block. So just copy this and here create and initialize it as null, and just remove this, and now we can use it here, con dot close, and it also throws one exception, so we have to use the try catch here also. So just simply press control 1, surround with try catch, okay? If you are not writing this finally block, it is okay, but in real time it is very useful to clear the resources. Okay, so I have closed the connection. Now let's see whether we are getting the data in the database or not. So let's run this application. Run as run on server. Initially you can see in my database select star from users table, there is no record present. Okay, you can see nothing is present here. So I think it is running. Okay, so let's just create account name. So I'm gonna provide as any name you can provide. Just let be Sunil, and this is my email ID and password and repeat password and contact number. Okay, and just click on register. You can see I'm getting this error because con is null. Okay, so connection is null. So what is the error? First we have to check the error. No suitable driver found for JDBC MySQL colon localhost 3306/YouTube. Okay, so why I'm getting this? Okay, so if you are getting this, let's try just one way. What we have to do is we have to put this MySQL connector.java jar file in the Apache Tomcat folder. So just go to download this. I have downloaded this MySQL connector. So just copy this and go to your Apache Tomcat 9 folder, and in the lib, I think here we have to paste this in the lib or in the bin. In the lib only, just paste in the lib folder. Okay, just I have pasted. Now just check one more time whether it is working or not. So we have to start. So just run as run on server. Now just go to create an account name, email, password and contact number, and click on register. Okay, still I'm facing that issue. No suitable driver. I have this mask JDBC colon. So colon. Okay. So sorry, I have entered the wrong URL. JDBC colon MySQL colon double slash should be there and localhost. My mistake. Okay, now let's just run on server. Restart the server. This is the machine where your MySQL is running. So if we are running on localhost, then put localhost. Otherwise we have to put the IP address of the server where your database is running. So name is Sunil, and email and password and repeat password and contact number. Okay, and click on register, and you can see we got our sign up page again. And let's check in the database whether we have got the data or not. So you can see I have got this one row. My username is email is this one, and password is this one. Okay, so that means registration is working properly, but we are not getting any message here like account created successfully. So for that, what we have to do is go to registration.jsp page. Here what you have to do, you have to add one more script. So just copy this CDN links. I will provide that in the comments, in the description. You will get that link. So script. Okay, sorry, script. Okay, script tag. Copy this to link. Basically I am using this sweet alert. There is a library called sweet alert. Okay, so to get the alert message we will use this library sweet alert. So Now, in what we have to do, first we have to create here a hidden field. So how to create a hidden field? Input type is equal to hidden, and just give it a id as status, and value will be, in the value we will store the this request dot get attribute and status. What it will return, what we are doing here is we are getting the status value from registration dot servlet. If we are whether the status is success or failed, okay. So the whatever status will be returned from here, suppose if the registration is successful, then the status will be success. If the registration is failed, then the status will be failed. So this input field will contain the status, like is this failed or success. So using this field, here we will write one script. So JavaScript script tag you have to use, and inside this we will get this value. So simply just where status is equal to document dot get element. I am using JavaScript, okay, element by id, and the id name is status dot value. And if we have to check if status equal to success, then what we will do, we will just use this swell method is there, I think swell method is there. Inside this we have to pass the message which we want to show to the user. So we will show account congrats. First we will show him congrats, then we will show congrats account created successfully, and it will be a success. Okay, now let's run and see whether it is working or not. So right click, sign in, run as, run on server, and finish, and just go to here and create one AA, and my email ID is this, and password is 123123, and any contact number you can enter, and click on register. Can see the details are inserted, but we have not got this message. Why we are getting this exception? So let's see, closing inbound. Okay, so we are getting one error. Let's just see. Okay friends, so I have identified the cause of this error. Actually the SSL connection is failing. So what we have to do is, in the our URL we have to simply use SSL equal to false. Okay, and now but we should get this icon, this value here, this one. If it is success, this win, then we should get this. So let me check my spelling, whether it is any spelling mistake is there or not. So let me just go here and check uncaught status is not defined. Okay, so I have one mistake, so yes, spelling mistake, it should be status. Now let's run this again, run as, run on server, next, and finish, and then you will be able to see the message, account created successfully. Okay, so it's running. So first we have to create account. So go to create account, name and email. So here I will enter different email, and now password, put password, and any click on register. Okay, the data is inserted. Still, we have not got. But you have noticed we are not getting that error. So if the status equal to success, then we should get this message. But why it is not working? So let me check in the console. It is not related to that. Okay, guys. So I have identified the issue why we are not getting that alert message. Account created successfully, because here we have by mistakenly added one arrow icon. This one you can see, close icon. So we have to just remove this one. Okay, so after removing this, if we run as non server, next, go to create an account, create one account, password is 456 456, and any you can enter, click on register. Now you can see I am getting this congress, account created successful. Okay, so registration part is done. Now we have to focus on the login page. So if user is already a member, here you can see a button, I am already member. So when he will click, he will get the sign up page. Now we have to work on the sign up module. Okay, so what we have to do for this, we have to go to the our sign up. Here you can see login.jsp. Here we have to, in the method, we have to put post and action should be login. Okay, and this action we will define now, servlet at that web server tag. So in the registration, create one more class, new servlet, and name is login. Okay, I don't need all these methods, only do post is required. And now you can see it should be login, so make it as login this one, and the login.jsp page, this name should be same. Okay, should be same. So now just get the username. So string uname equal to, let's make it u email, because we are getting email. U email equal to request dot get parameter, and what is the name for the field we have to check. Go to login.jsp, you can see it is username. Okay, so name is username, so copy and log here, paste username. Similarly, we will create one more for upwd, means password. And what is the field name for password? It is password only. Okay, you can see name is password. Paste is here. We will give, then we will got our username and password. Now we will write our database code, try catch, and here we will use the load. If you are not using the class dot for name method, it's okay, because after I think from Java 7 or 8 we don't need to write this, but for simplicity I will write for name com dot mysql dot jdbc dot driver, and let's create a connection. Con is equal to driver manager dot get, not dot get connection. Let me just copy my URL from my registration servlet. So just copy this URL. Okay, and here I have to put one, so I have copied that, and now we will create a prepare statement object. PST is equal to con dot prepare statement, and here we will add our query. Select star from table name is users, where u email equal to question mark, and u pwd equal to question mark. Okay, so where you email will be this question mark, and upwd will be this. Now we have to set the values for these two parameter. So what this query will check, this will check the user the UEMAIL and UPWD provided by the user is existed in the database or not. So if let just set the values, psc.set string first is UEMAIL, and the second one is UPWD. Okay, now make sure this name should be same as your database name. Okay, database column name. If I show you here, you can see UEMAIL and UPWD, UEMAIL and UPWD. Okay, and this name is this name, the variables which we have declared. And now we have to execute pst.execute. This is select query, so we have to use this execute query method. Okay, execute query. Now it will return us a result set. So result set rs, and now we will check if rs.next means if the result set has data, means we got the record in the database, that is why the result have the next record. So if the next record is present, that means the user is existed in the database. Now we will make him as a valid user, and we will redirect this user to the our landing page or home page. Okay, so rs.next, then this is a valid user. So what we have to do, we have to just have request dot set attribute. We have to set one attribute, set attribute status. Status is not required. We can simply set one, you can say one session. Okay, session, you have to create one session object. Okay, so why session? You remember here we have in the register, in the index.jsp page, we have set this attribute in the session. Okay, name. So we have to set this attribute name. So for creating session, here I will create http session is equal to request dot get session. Okay, and session dot set attribute, set attribute name, and the name will be rs dot get string, not get statement, it should be get string. Get string, and what will be the u name, and after that we will create request dispatches. We will create dispatcher. So request dispatcher is equal to null, and here if the user have login successful, then we will set dispatcher is equal to request, not this, request dot get request dispatcher, and the page name will be index.jsp. We will redirect him to the JSP page. Okay, index.jsp page, our home page. And if the record is not present, else means the data is not exist, the user is not present in the database, that means the user have provided wrong username and password. Okay, so what we have to do is here we have to use the request dot set attribute. We will set one attribute. Okay, set attribute status, and here we will mention as failed, and the dispatcher is equal to request dot get request dispatcher, and we will go to this login dot jsp page. Okay, and login dot jsp page. Now what we have to do, we have to simply call dispatcher dot forward request and response. Okay, and just print the exception here, e dot print struct test method. Now in the at the login.jsp page, we have to write same logic which we have written in the registration.jsp page to show the pop-up. So copy this field here in the login, paste it here in the body, and simply just copy this below script tag and the above to CDN for sweet alert. Okay, and paste it in here after the script tag. Just paste this. Okay, I have pasted these two link and this one. So if the status is failed, that means sorry, wrong username or password. Okay, and the type will be failed. Now let's just run and check whether it is working or not. So run as run on server, sorry, not Java application, we have to run it as run on server. So run as run on server. Finish. Now just let me enter my username password and let me check the password in the database. So you can see the password is 123. Okay, so if I enter 123 and click on login, then you can see I am getting this our landing page, but I am not getting my name here. So I will show you how to get this. So if I go back and if I enter something wrong password and click on login, then you can see sorry user wrong username and password, but I am not getting this wrong icon. Why? Because we have to provide error as a type. Okay, so here instead of failed we have to provide error, so it will be a error message. Okay, now what we have to do, you can see after login I am not getting that, let me show you, I am not getting my name here. Okay, and when user will click on logout, it is not going to logout na, so we have to do that. So how, what we have to do, go to your index.jsp. Here in the menu, so after the logout, in the logout, in the href, you have to pass logout, and we will create another servlet for this. And for showing the username, just copy this li tag and paste it here. Okay, and here in the class, just specify bg danger, which is a bootstrap class. And here logout, instead of logout we have to provide one tag, not this, and here we will say session, the value which we have set in the session dot get attribute and name, it will return us the username. Okay, and now we have to map this logout also. So for when user will click on this logout button, the request will go to this logout and it will be logged out. Okay, so just here in the registration, create one more servlet, logout. Okay, and remove this, it will be a get, so we have to use the do get, not a do post. Okay, because whenever we are using any anchor tag, and with the anchor tag we are by default it uses do get, okay, and logout, and this logout should be same as this one, where it is index.jsp, this logout and this logout should be same, okay. Now here simply what we have to do, we have to just destroy the session. So how to, first you have to get this session, not http servlet, http session, session is equal to request dot get session, and simply do session dot invalidate, and just simply redirect to the user, send redirect to the login.jsp page, okay. So I think we have done everything. Now let's run and check our application working or not. So finish, okay. Okay, so I am directly getting this page, but what happened, let me check in the index.jsp. okay, we have made one mistake here. So first, why I am getting this, because it is already running. First I need to stop the server, close all the already, because in this session the value is present. Okay, now let's just simply run this, run as Java application. Oh, not sorry, not Java application. What is going on? Run as run on server. Actually, it's 3 o'clock in the night. I am feeling very sleepy. That is why. Okay, and why I'm getting this directly, this page log, make a logout and login again, password is 123. You can see I'm getting my username here, but how I'm seeing this? So let me just do one logout one time. In the index.jsp I have written set attribute name, and I'm getting that here, session dot get attribute. Okay, now let's check run as non server and finish. Okay, you can see now we are getting the sign in page. We are not, why? Because previously we have logged in and session one was present in the cache, you can say. So we have to destroy the session. That is what we are doing. When user will click on this logout, the request will go to this logout.java, and here it will invalidate the session, it will destroy the session, and it will go to login.jsp. okay, so I hope you understand this video. This video got very long, I am sorry for that. So thanks for watching. If you have not subscribed the channel, do subscribe the channel. Let's see you in the next video. Thank you, bye bye.